Hello everyone, and welcome back to another Heart of Micron video. Today we're joined by one of our most brave team members from Micron. Daniela Bazzana is part of Micron's team in Italy, and she has been providing a volunteering effort to support so many resources in one of the hardest hit regions of Italy during the COVID-19 pandemic. Daniela, thank you so much for joining us. And Daniela is also joined by Chiara Rovelli, who is going to be helping translate so that we can make sure that Daniela is comfortable getting her story out to all of Micron. So thank you to both of you for joining us here today.
Thank you.
So Daniela, please, let's start by talking a little bit about where you work at Micron and what you do there. And then maybe Chiara also, if you have a moment when you are translating for Daniela, tell us a little bit about yourself as well, so we know your role at Micron.
Daniela, vuoi raccontarci che cosa fai in Micron? Qual è il tuo ruolo?
Lavoro da 18 anni in ST Pneumonics Micron e attualmente lavoro nel gruppo degli RMA nei resi clienti. Sono un tecnico di laboratorio.
So I've been working in Micron since 18 years, and I was working formerly in ST Microelectronics, then Pneumonics. Pneumonics was acquired by Micron, and I'm a technician in the quality lab in Vimercate, and I'm working on the RMA from customers.
And Chiara, I understand that you are a senior HR business partner with us in Micron in EMEA, is that right?
Yes, exactly. I'm a senior HR business partner in EMEA supporting various organizations, including Global Quality.
And of course, also a part-time translator, it seems today.
Yes. I'm helping Daniela to respond to all the questions.
Well, let's get back to Daniela. And Daniela, I understand that your volunteer work was specifically with the elderly near Bergamo, which is one of the most hard hit areas in Italy. Tell us a little bit more about your experience and the volunteer work that you have done during the pandemic.
Daniela, sappiamo che hai fatto questo lavoro di volontariato, sei stata volontaria in alcune strutture a Bergamo durante la pandemia. Ci vuoi raccontare un po' questa tua esperienza?
Sì, per forza, sono qua. Allora, il lavoro era rivolto a tutte le persone affette da Covid nella Bergamasca, che avevano bisogno di assistenza inoltrando specifica domanda alla cooperativa. Non c'è molto da raccontare, non è stata una bellissima esperienza. È stata intensa, drammatica, mi ha insegnato tante cose, ma non bella. Sono emozioni forti quelle che ho provato e purtroppo non hanno ancora coniato un nome adatto per spiegarle, mi dispiace.
Yes, I would tell something. I'm here for this reason today. So they have not yet created a name or some words to tell you or translate what I have felt during this experience. So I'm sorry if I cannot put into words my emotion and feelings. I've been in a different structure in the Bergamo area. I've been called from a non-profit social cooperative to work in different sites there to assist patients that were infected by COVID and were residents in those structures. So it has been, she said also that it has been a hard experience. So it has been a very good experience for her, but really hard, and she has nothing more to say regarding this.
Well, and we can only imagine how difficult and how much of a toll that it must have taken on you doing this volunteering experience. I wonder if you could tell us a little bit more about what was a day like during your month that you were volunteering in Bergamo. What was sort of the experience like for you during a typical day?
Daniela, possiamo immaginare quanto sia stata dura questa esperienza per te. Puoi raccontarci una giornata tipo di quelle che hai vissuto e farci capire proprio che cosa hai fatto lì?
Beh, allora, non posso darti un orario perché non vi è orario traslitto.
Okay, so I cannot give you an exact time of my day because really there was no time at all in each day, so it was impossible to have an exact time of when the day start and when the day finish.
Dormivamo circa 2 o 3 ore a notte, notte o giorno, dipendeva dal flusso di lavoro. So che sono dimagrita 7 kg in 23 giorni, quindi un po' di livello di stress c'era magari.
So normally we did sleep 2, 3 hours per night or per day, depending on the work that we have to do. And I can tell you that I have lost 7 kilos in more than 20 days, 23 days, if I well understood. And so you can even imagine the level of stress that we had during our days.
Generalmente andavo alla mattina alle 6, iniziavo in una delle strutture, verificavo tutti i parametri a tutti i pazienti, blisteravo le medicine e mi consultavo con i medici per le terapie da somministrargli. In caso di mancanza del personale, essendo debilitati, ho provato anche a lavarli, a pulirli, a sistemare i pazienti.
So normally I started at 6 a.m. and I went to one of the structure and I consult with the doctors. I prepare the medicines for the patients and sometimes if it was needed, I also wash them and prepare them because the staff was not there. So I did that also for them.
Finita una struttura, andavo nell'altra per fare la medesima cosa. Alle 17 poi andavo da Giulia, una paziente di 53 anni, carinissima, e dovevo fargli fare fisioterapia per 90 minuti tutti i giorni. Lei era stata infettata e quando è andata in ospedale ha avuto problemi di ipossia che gli ha compromesso tutta la mobilità. Ho dovuto quindi fargli riabilitazione in quanto il cervello non riusciva più a coordinare i movimenti ed era in carrozzina.
Normally we finish at 5 p.m. In the structure, in the first structure, and then I move to the other ones because I serve in more than one structure in the Bergamo area. And when I finish with all the structure, I took care of a patient, a woman of 53 years old woman, Julia, a very, very nice person. She was infected by COVID, and when she came back, she suffered from hypoxia. So she was needing a particular therapy, and I did take care of her each day.
È stata dura, però l'abbiamo recuperata, non al 100%, ma quasi. È stata una soddisfazione.
It has been very hard with Julia, not because of the person, of course, but because of the illness that she was going through. But we have recovered her almost 100%, so we have done it. Good, great.
Alla sera invece andavamo dai pazienti a domicilio per valutare e dare loro le cure del caso. Riportavamo poi i dati all'ATS di competenza. Di notte invece ero responsabile della sicurezza per la sanificazione con l'ozono che è obbligatoria per poter tenere aperte le strutture. Se tutto andava bene, alle 3 di notte forse riuscivo ad andare a letto e almeno 2 ore di sonno riuscivo a farle. Però è capitato anche che non le facessi.
So after taking care of all the patients in the structure, after the therapy with Julia, I moved to visit the patients that were recovered by their houses because they needed assistance as well. So I went there and visited them and gave them the medicine. And then when we came back during night, I was responsible for also for the sanitizations of the structures. So I had also this responsibility. And when we finished all, maybe I was able to go and sleep at least 3 hours each night.
It's really... It's incredible to hear how much responsibility you had to shoulder and take on during this time, from everything from caring for the elderly patients, where there was such an overflow of patients during this critical time, then providing physical therapy to this patient, Julia, and then finally to cleaning all of the, helping maintain the, you know, the sanitation and the cleanliness of these facilities. It's quite an extraordinary effort that you have put in, Daniela, and I think we are all really, I think, humbled and touched to hear of your commitment to all of this.
Daniela, è incredibile sentire quante responsabilità hai avuto e come le hai affrontate, di come tu ti sia presa cura di tutte queste persone. Immaginiamo che non deve essere stato semplice, siamo veramente molto colpiti da questa cosa e siamo anche contenti e che tu l'abbia fatto in questo modo.
And I think what I also wanted to ask you was, I understand that Micron helped you make your volunteering work possible by giving you time off during this time. Could you tell us what that means to you to have been able to take on this difficult experience? But I understand that volunteering is quite a passion of yours.
Daniela, Micron ti ha, abbiamo capito che Micron ti ha dato, ti ha riservato del tempo per poter fare questa esperienza di volontariato. Vorremmo capire da te, ci piacerebbe sapere che cosa questo ha significato per te, se ce lo puoi raccontare.
Allora, Micron ha dato dimostrazione ancora una volta di essere una grande azienda. Ha dato un'ulteriore prova ai suoi dipendenti che non sono numeri ma persone. Io ogni giorno che passa sono sempre più orgogliosa di Micron. Lo so che è sempre la stessa cosa che ripeto, però è vero.
So Micron has demonstrated once again that is really a great company, and I'm really proud to be part of this company. And I know that probably I've already said this, but I would like to repeat. Micron has demonstrated that people are not numbers, but they are really human, they are people. So this is what Daniela said.
Sono partita tante volte in missione, le persone mi chiedono perché lo fai, Dani, ma per il mio la domanda corretta sarebbe perché non bisogna farlo.
So, people are asking me, why, Daniela, are you doing this? And I believe that this is not the good question. But the most correct question should be why I should not done this.
Io ogni mattina voglio potermi guardare allo specchio ed essere fiera di me. Non voglio vergognarmi di quello che avrei potuto fare, ma non ho fatto, magari solo per codardia. Io ci sono cose nella vita che vanno fatte indipendentemente dalla paura e da quello che pensano le persone. Alcune cose si fanno semplicemente perché è giusto farle.
I think that I would like to wake up each day and look myself into the mirror and be proud of what I am because of what I've done. There are things that in life you have to do. There are some things you have to do and have to be done, and so you have to go and done them, and you have to be courageous to do this. You have not to fear them.
Se fossi stata io al loro posto a Bergamo, avrei pregato che ci fossero delle persone che potessero venirmi ad aiutare. Io ho fatto solo il mio dovere, nulla di più.
If I were one of those people in Bergamo, I would have prayed to have someone who could have helped me. So I believe that I've just done my duty.
Strong words of example that we're hearing from Daniela Bazzana, our team member, calling all of us to think about and reflect on why not us, why not do the kind of work and action and service to our communities that she's done. So Daniela, thank you so much for giving us such a great example of how we can really live our values and give back to our communities. And we really appreciate everything that you've done. And thank you for sharing your story with us here on Heart of Micron.
Daniela, grazie per quello che ci hai raccontato, grazie per la tua storia e grazie perché ci hai dimostrato che cosa può essere fatto. Siamo molto contenti di questo, siamo molto contenti di poter raccontare la tua storia a tutti e di raccontarla e condividerla con la comunità. Grazie ancora.
Grazie a voi.
Tune in next time when we bring you another amazing story from our team members at the Heart of Micron. Thanks so much for tuning in.